clutching what little possessions they have left and wrapped up against the biting cold. These people are demanding Serbian authorities let them pass into Hungary. At a sit-in protest in the border village Kalabija, they hold signs demanding they be allowed into Hungary, a member of the European Union.
I didn't go there to get money from the European Union. I'm only looking for a better life. You know, my country have a war. I cannot go back to Syria.
It's not just Syrians trying to cross. Refugees from Afghanistan, Iraq, Yemen and other countries have found themselves here after fleeing war, poverty and persecution. As Serbian police follow their protests and Hungarian police block the border fence, they're left with few options.
We don't have a way to back and no way to run. That's why we are here, and last night we are here, and today we are here also, and the weather is so bad. You know, this is winter. Yeah, this is winter. We have kids, we have children, we have women pregnant, we have old guys.
We will stay here.
We don't have no choice.
When they give permission to go in border, we will go.
Last month, Hungarian police fired warning shots when dozens of people attempted to cross the border.
It was a violent group that attempted to break in, carried out with violent behaviour by young, organised men.
The route was shot off and fences erected with razor wire after hundreds of thousands passed through Balkan countries 5 years ago. Hungary's Prime Minister Viktor Orban has made clear refugees are not welcome and has threatened to use force against them. Across the border in Serbia, there are now more than 6,000 refugees living in government-run camps. They want to leave, but getting into the EU has become increasingly harder. Laura Burdon-Manley, Al Jazeera.